I copy that. Has everybody gone
copy.
Quiet?
Yeah, pretty much.
I thought I'd lost connection.
Stop reifying connections.
I was thinking earlier today about how people are trained to be fearful of going against authority. You know, from a young age, we're taught, you know, not to oppose authority. And that feeds very, very much into this topic, I think, and people's abilities to let go of what authorities have taught us.
I think they miscategorized authorities, because pseudoscientists are not authorities.
But in the realm of science,
by nature, be authoritative.
Say again, Paul.
Shouldn't the truth, by its very nature, be authoritative?
Authoritative is the wrong word. It's empirical. The empiricism that is asked for here is the level and standard that is asserted. The two aren't the same, but they're used interchangeably by fundamentalist religious zealot globeheads. In other words, when they say science, they mean pseudoscience. As an example, science doesn't prove anything. Well, yes, science is an empirical method of establishing cause and effect based on systematic experimentation by way of hypotheses. So, science definitely does prove things. But what they've actually been using is pseudoscience. And pseudoscience doesn't prove anything. And may be subject to change. So, they change their just-so story, otherwise known as pseudoscience, whilst simultaneously asserting to their audience that they've got science. And when caught out, they simply say, oh, well, science doesn't prove anything, it just lends to the evidence. Evidence being proof, proof being empiricism, proof being actual science that they don't have.
And notice how the narrative is all fucked up, because one of them came in and said, oh, it's a closed system. Immediately, the next one said it's open. So, which one is it again?
It's claimed to be an open system. So the heliocentric, reified sphere model world of a globe Earth in a vacuum is claimed to be an open system. They've got things traveling out from the claimed to be sphere Earth with gas pressure attached, not dispersing into the sky vacuum, out into the sky vacuum to visit these strange alien worlds, which we as flat earthers simply refer to as lights in the sky. Claim to be vast bodies of rocks and gases not dispersing also into the vacuum of the sky. So the whole bullshit narrative falls apart by application of the second law of thermodynamics. These claim to be gas bodies that they travel out to through their open system also violate the second law of thermodynamics, as does the gas pressure we experience here on Earth.
Yeah, you can't have a closed system exchanging matter, because a closed system doesn't exchange matter. So if you have something exchanging matter, by definition, it's not a closed system. Duh.
Well, but Puppy Lover in the Discord live stream says it's an approximation QE, where it's approximately closed.
No, you can't have approximately. You can't have approximately here. It either is or is not. It's either a one or a zero. So
in reality,
you can't be a little pregnant.
In reality, it's either exchanging matter or it isn't. In their model, you can do whatever you like. You know, you can change the values, you can have approximately open systems, you can have gas pressure not dispersing into vacuums. You can do all sorts of crazy nonsense in a model. We don't live on a model, though.
Yeah, you just press the matter button, and matter is allowed to leave the closed system.
Or
as simple as that. Press the button,
Or you drag a little hatch. Or you drag a little slider and bend light. You know, things like that. You can do all sorts of crazy stuff in models. But we don't live on them.
The sky vacuum is the limit.
Yeah, the sky's definitely
not. You can math anything you want.
A curvature. The housekeeping question, any signs of Earth curvature, is based around them reifying the horizon into an edge. So the edge that we get asked for, no, that's their projection of the fact that they utilize a reified horizon edge in their model when they transpose their model by way of reification into the actual existence we experience. Well, their edge is a not actual location we would accurately call the horizon. A not actual location where they have boats going over when they simultaneously ignore perspective. So let's ignore the fact that it's reducing an angular size, give it a constant fixed value of 100 foot. That 100 foot boat's going over that reified edge of my sphere belief. Oi, flat earther, where's your edge? What are you talking about? I don't claim any edge, but you've got an edge. Boats are going over it, you moron. Take me to your edge.
So Brenda just posted something in Discord, a definition that Earth is a closed system and that mass does not pass through it.
Yeah, this is where we got to on the last live show. So Brenda, what's the score with Voyager then? How's it getting where it's getting? Is that just a big fat lie? We know anyway it can't be where it is. It's in the sky vacuum, which can't possibly be real. But by your standards in your model, not reality. How does Voyager leave your model that's closed?
It's an article from physics.org that actually says that the atmosphere is leaking. So, okay, go ahead.
Yeah, it's leaking spaceships.
I posted 5 sources saying the Earth is a closed system. Because
anyone could say anything.
There's sources.
Define a closed system. Define a closed system.
Yeah, I'm asking how Voyager left it closed. Do you not? I don't care about the source. I haven't even read. I'm not interested. I'm asking how bloody Voyager leaves a closed system. Is there a hatch like in Spaceballs?
It's a closed system refers to the systems of the Earth. It doesn't what? Refer. It does. It Sorry, refers to the Earth's systems.
Question. Specific question about how Voyager leaves. If it's closed, no matter's escaping. That would be matter. How's it escaping from your model, this heliocentric model? Not the reality we live in, because the sky is definitely not a vacuum. But based on your reified religious belief in a heliocentric model, how is Voyager leaving if it's closed? That's my question. Not about sources or what open and closed are. How's Voyager leaving?
Voyager isn't part of the thermodynamic equilibrium systems of the Earth.
The fuck?
And how is that possible if it's closed? How did it leave a closed system? Is it got a hatch like in Spaceballs?
Now, people know that Voyager left the Earth. It's not part
of Voyager matter.
Closed. I've asked 5 times. You're saying it's closed. I'm saying if it's closed, not people believe it's left. I'm saying if it's closed, how the hell did it get out? Is there a hatch like in Spaceballs?
Everybody knows that it left the Earth. Everybody knows that.
I don't want to be told what everybody knows. What I wanted was an answer. How the hell is Voyager leaving if you claim it's closed? Not what everybody knows, you stupid girl.
I was in Discord if you want him unmuted.
Who?
P-Mars.
It's your choice.
No.
Now we got enough stupidity.
No.
You're a while. Let's see how well he behaves.
I got him up.
Be nice. Hey, P.
Hello.
That's a woman?
Mars is a man.